Flack stood with Lucky and 55. They were in a secret room, rarely used by members of Rico's brigade. It was actually a safe room in case their ship ever got boarded. Flack, how did the meeting with Rico go? Was he willing to undergo treatment? 55, I'm glad you rushed here from the racket mission, but why do you think we're having this meeting if he agreed to undergo treatment? All right, no need to get snippy. Yeah, I'm sorry about that. I'm a bit on edge. No, he obviously didn't want to go get treatment. In fact, he's speaking more radically than ever. Yes, he's certainly not in a good place. Lucky the medic chimed in. I've certainly seen men go mad from the pressure of leadership, but this is extreme. And Rico seemed perfectly normal up until this point. It was rare for him to lose his cool so suddenly. I'm concerned there may be more at play here than we initially see. What kind of things, Doctor? I won't speak on it until it's confirmed. Very well. Though maybe you should seek some help from Dr. Schlieffen? Schlieffen? That guy's a nut job. But he does have some knowledge of dark science. Maybe I will employ his help. Very well. But we still need to get Rico apprehended to operate on him. So Flack, what you're saying is that this coup is turning violent? I'm afraid so. Rico's loyal guard will protect him no matter what. But we can set our blasters to stun and keep everyone unharmed. They're just following orders. Right. I'll prep the 501st and we'll storm his position tonight. Remember, boys, we're doing the right thing. Our leader, our friend, needs help. Off in the galaxy, the Dutchman stood at the helm of his ship. He had watched as his allies had failed the missions that the Emperor had set forth for them to do. But he had bided his time. He wouldn't get captured like Fox and Cody, and he surely wouldn't get bogged down like Tarkin did on Hoth. Instead, he would lie in wait, preparing for the enemy to be caught off guard, and then pounce on them. He was patient, determined to be seen as valuable in the eyes of the Emperor. Commander Rico stood next to a gonk droid that had been in a safe room with 55, Flack, and Lucky. Good morning, my gonk friend. Spying on those fools was a stroke of genius. It just breaks my heart that they would betray me like this. Nonetheless, I must be ready for them. I'll prepare the guard on Dantooine. It's possibly the strongest fortress in my possession. These traitors will be stopped. What's up, gamers? It's me, Daily Tactics here, and today we are back with another episode of Star Wars Rico's Brigade, and the coup is commencing. The 501st Legion, under the command of Commander 55, as well as his second-hand man, Glasdin, and Flack is just an honorary member today. They are taking on Rico's personal guard, because Rico is in desperate need of a psych evaluation here. Something is going on. We don't know exactly what yet, but the man has certainly lost his mind. He's going a little nuts. Here he is right here. He is literally defending against his own brothers who are just trying to help him right now. Things are not looking good for the brigade. So the 501st is going to be barreling through these defenses, or at least trying to, in an attempt to get to Rico. They have their blasters all set to stun as to not kill Rico's brigade members here, because these guys are just following orders and they are extremely loyal to Rico. They are his personal legion. Yeah, it really says something about these guys. So either way, guys, we're gonna get right on into it here. I hope you enjoy this series. I've been having a ton of fun making it lately. Be sure to comment down below what you thought of the episode and what you think might happen next. Subscribe if you haven't already, and be sure to smash that like button. Let's try and get 1200 likes in the first 24 hours. And without further ado, let's get into it, boys. Okie dokie then, fellers. We're going ahead and pressing start. Let's go ahead and a little cheeky little slow-mo for the start. And here we go. The 501st is marching forward. This really reminds me of, and you know, to try and guess, hey, what does this remind you of? Another Star Wars moment. And my answer is Operation Nightfall. When the 501st Legion was ascending the steps to the Jedi Temple to commit Order 66. This has the same vibe, you know, except in this case, it's, you know, for a good cause rather than for Emperor Palpatine. You know, this is actually honorable, whereas before they were just slaughtering people, including younglings. Very epic, very pog, am I right, guys? Big chungus. Alright, well, the 501st is taking some losses here right off the bat, but they've got numbers, you know? They can soak up a lot of this damage. Not to mention, they've basically created a firing wall over here. Like, this is just dudes upon dudes upon dudes firing away. Like, this is epic, actually. They have, like, 0% chance of getting suppressed given how many troopers they have right here, and they are taking full advantage of this, just launching laser after laser at the defenders. That is, like, that's a pro strat, just firing wall. Why didn't anyone ever think of this? Just layer your troopers upon each other and just absolutely launch your attack. Just absolutely out-defend the defenders by using defenses. That's epic. I love that. This is awesome. They are straight up destroying Rico's personal guard here, causing all of the free roamers to retreat backwards, and the troopers who are in the defensive positions over here are just getting thwacked by incoming fire. This is a truly big baller move here by the 501st Legion. They did take some losses at the start of this battle, but once they got that firing wall set up, baby, oh man, did they slaughter. Oh man, did they absolutely clap some cheeks here, boys. It was absolutely incredible right there. And we've got Glasdin right there, we've got Flak right there, and I did hear a DC-15X go off. That means 55 is still alive. He's the only trooper on the field with one of those. I just don't see him. I just straight up don't see him. He does sort of blend in with the rest of the 501st troopers because his armor is very similar. Ah, there he is. You can always tell by the backpack. There's 55, my boy! The commanders do have a little bit extra health than the other troopers. They have 1,000 health. Meanwhile, the regular 501st and Rico troopers each have a mere 100 health. And that's because, you know, they're commander units. We want to see them battle. We want to see them, you know, be able to survive a little bit longer. And the unfortunate reality of this game is that, you know, sometimes a commander will just go in within 5 seconds of the battle starting and die instantly, and that's not fun for anyone, you know? Alright, the Rico units on the exterior of this little compound that Rico is holding out in are crumbling. These units are just in absolute disaster mode right now, maybe scrambling to recover at least a little bit, but it's just not working. They're mainly getting suppressed. The boys in the back are just not able to help out the guys in the front in the slightest. This is end times for the outside defenses here. Yeah, they're probably not going to get a single extra 501st kill here. They're probably just going to fall without managing to do anything. However, they still do have the interior defenses here. And if you look at this area, this is choke point after choke point after choke point. Like, these boys are going to defend with the best of them, you know? Oh, they actually did get a 501st kill right there. Impressive stuff right there. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. So I think the choke points on the interior might be a turning point in the battle, but the 501st initial assault here made it through the outside defenses way better than I ever would have thought. Let's look at the deaths here. So yellow are dead Rico members, and red are dead 501st members, of course, all set to stun. But, I mean, Rico lost like 4 or 5 times as many troopers as the 501st. I mean, in all honesty, the outside defenses here were maybe like half the size of Rico's troopers, so they were a very size, or half the size of 55's troopers, sorry, I misspoke there. So, you know, a very chonky defense on the exterior, and yet they got wiped out, and I think that was truly due to the power of the firing squad wall. Like, I think that helped genuinely so much. Now, of course, the defenses will get harder, but there will be less troopers back here because so many of Rico's troopers ended up going down on the exterior there. So we'll see if they manage to make a bit of a comeback here. I don't know if they'll manage to, because let's be honest, the 501st is drastically outnumbering them now. You know, before it was about even in terms of numbers, like through and through, the total 501st versus the total Rico Guard numbers were about even, but now I'd say Rico's Guard is down about half of their troopers, and, you know, the 501st are down maybe like an eighth of their troopers. They're at a serious deficit right now, the defenders. It's not looking too hot. We got an MITR trooper spraying down some of these Rico troopers, but not managing to really do all that much. The 501st seems to have a lot of lingering going on. I think some people might actually be stuck in this area. That's something that the boys always are doing. They're always getting themselves stuck behind those walls. So let's open that up for them, and maybe that'll unglitch them a little bit. But they're doing the trickle in, which is never a good thing. Like, really, if you've got the numbers, if you've got number superiority, yeetus, deletus the enemy. Just full on charge forward. There is no point in you lollygagging around. Just full send, baby. Full send it. And then you'll just crush them. You will crush the defenses if you manage to do that. However, that's not what's going on here. We are getting the trickle in going on right now. We're getting the trickle down theory. The Reaganomics are in full swing, baby. Full swing. And that didn't work in the 80s. we need the hero units up here, honestly. These guys can tank shots, so you know, maybe clearing choke points would be the best thing for them to do, because they can help so much with their beefiness. Except we are getting a bit more of a charge going in here, so now Rico's members are in fact having to duck and cover. There's some good fire going out with grenades as well. Rico himself, he's the grenadier of Daily Squad. His troopers are getting grenaded. It's a little gotcha moment there. It's a little 180 with his own strategy. But yeah, they're finally managing to clear this choke point, but not before taking some extreme losses. And in fact, they are still taking some losses here. Rico's troopers are not going down without a fight. I mean, this is their leader they're talking about here. Uh-oh. All right. The boys are in the front lines here. Flak and Glazian, why don't you guys chill a little bit? I don't want you guys just yeeting forward and getting yourselves killed. I don't want that happening. You guys are doing a good job partaking in the battle, but there's no point in losing you guys like that. All right, here we go. The 501st is moving in here. There's a lot of death going on. It's a lot of chaos. This room is just a cesspool of random things happening. Grenades getting thrown every which way. Laser fire going everywhere. People dying. People dropping to the ground. I don't know what's happening. Okay, I think the room got cleared. It took a little bit of 501st muscle right there to manage to do that, but they did manage, and they cleared that room pretty well. Okay, next major choke point is going to be right here. These guys in here are going to have a killer defense right in like this boxy area, and there's dudes over here too who can also help out, except they are not noticing. Oh, there we go. All right, 501st getting bogged down right here once again, right where I predicted that choke point would end up being. The 501st does clear this room, though, a little bit faster than I actually would have anticipated them being able to do that. So that was impressive right there. That was a good breach and clear. But now the breach and clear over here is not really happening. Once again, we have mass deaths over here. It's not looking too hot. There we go. We're getting a few kills in there. Not bad. Not bad at all. They're funneling more troopers in there. It does look like they're going for the mass assault sort of move, and it's working. They are clearing out these defenses through their extreme pressure that they're applying to them. So that was good. Still lots of losses, but they managed to do it. A couple more units right over here. They're getting a few kills on these 501st. Seems like they kind of got the drop on them, but the area does get cleared. We got another corner right here that could be pretty devastating for the attackers. Lots of crossfire coming in here. They do push in. They're taking some losses, but they are getting troops into optimal positions for maybe some grenades, as well as disruption. So that's good. Yep, and the dominoes start falling. That's how it's done, baby. I mean, one misstep and your entire defense can crumble, especially when going up against an enemy with so many troopers. We're now down to just Rico's defense here. I think his defenses fell way faster than I ever anticipated them falling. This was actually pretty crazy how fast Rico's defenses fell, given how many troopers he had lined up and how many choke points he had. So Rico does end up going down there, stunned. And, you know, he's still alive. All of his troopers are still alive. They were just following orders. But now he is captured, and he is going to be able to be evaluated by Lucky and see what the heck is going on in that man's brain. All right, if we check out the losses here, the losses for the 501st did end up picking up inside here. Yellow are dead 501st. Red are dead Rico's troopers, and of course, again, by dead, I mean just stunned. I think the big folly in Rico's defense here was the outside. The outside fell without any fight. They had, like, no fight in them. They got barely any kills. The interior was great, and I think if more 501st troopers died on the outside, then the interior might have actually managed to hold out and do it. And, yeah, that's where Rico sort of crumbled on the exterior here. It was not good. I don't know what got into his troopers. I think the firing squad really intimidated them, and they weren't able to suppress that squad, and it resulted in them just getting swept, basically. And then the free roamers kind of panicked and ran away, and in running away, they kind of got slaughtered. I mean, you can see these are the free roamers here. They were all running backwards and dying. It's not a good time. It's not a good time. The blaster turrets also fell too early. I think if they had managed to keep these things up and alive a little bit longer, we would have had a better time for Rico's troopers. But I thought it was an interesting battle. I hope you guys enjoyed too. Be sure to comment down below what you thought. Subscribe if you haven't already and smash the like button. Also, I have a new Daily Thoughts documentary style video on the super popular game right now, Among Us. I think it's one of the best videos I think I've ever made on YouTube. So if you guys would be interested in watching that, I would surely appreciate it. I'm putting my all into those videos, and I hope that can be seen, and I hope you guys are into them, because I think they're awesome. I think they're doing well. And I'd like more people to watch them, because I put so much effort into them. And I really appreciate it if you guys do go check those out, because they certainly do mean a lot to me. They're sort of a passion project right now, and I'm really digging them. And I think I will do a ton more of them in the future. Either way, guys, thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Comment down below. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.
I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Be sure to click that subscribe button for more content, and hit the notification bell if you'd like to be alerted to whenever I live stream or upload. Thanks so much.